A lot of that is because of the supporting cast, but one player in particular who should be in the most improved player conversation, Desmond Bane, has been utterly outstanding. What have you seen from him on the court and off the court to where he's been able to make this transition?
Well, the biggest thing for Desmond Bane has been the increased use in terms of ball handling. We always knew from last season that he was a very good standstill jump shooter, makes threes at a high clip. But what he has really started to work on and what this team has urged him to work on was being able to play off of the dribble some more. This summer at Summer League, they use him as point guard exclusively so that they can continue to work on his ball handling. So his ability to stand still, shoot threes, the ability to play off the dribble, but also for a young player, he uses down screens extremely well. Whether a defender is trailing, he curls. When the curl, a dribble, pull-up jump shot. If you try to shoot the gap, he steps back and shoots the basketball. His basketball IQ on the offensive end has continued to grow, and defensively, he has started to really buckle down at that two-guard position.
Yes, indeed, and you speak about that backcourt. When you talk about those two players, you talk about Bane, but then also you have Ja Morant, who definitely should be an all-star this season when you've seen what he's been able to do when healthy. Just talk about Ja Morant and his development, and what did you see from him specifically when he was hurt? What was he working on to keep his mind engaged and involved with the team?
Well, the biggest thing is he is like a coach on the floor for the team. So the times that he was down, he was still coaching from the bench. And his team really missed his influence when he was gone with the health and safety protocols. But we all know that he is a highlight waiting to happen on the floor. Doesn't get enough credit for his basketball IQ also in terms of being able to get guys in positions where they can be at their best. He's an end-of-the-game winner because he wants the basketball. He has so many different ways that he can score, as we saw in that Phoenix Suns game. And at the end of the day, this team loves him. And when your point guard is your leader and guys are willing to follow him, then more times than not, you can have success. He is knocking on the door of becoming a superstar at some point in this league, and his progression and being able to knock down mid-range shots, he knocked down the three-pointer in Phoenix, is going to continue to make him one of the toughest guards in the league.
No question about it. I mean, obviously, we see that was his seventh game scoring over 30 or more. Grizzlies have been utterly impressive. The only team to beat the Phoenix Suns on their home floor and the Golden State Warriors and the Utah Jazz, so they're impressive. But there's somebody at the top putting it all together. And you mentioned something. You said being at their best. Talk about Taylor Jenkins and his influence and impact on this team.
Well, Taylor Jenkins and this staff has been absolutely fantastic, and you can tell that their message has been getting across to this basketball team because from 1 to 15, they can put guys in the game that go in and produce. And the best way of showing that is when your best player is down, you're still able to go out and go 10-2 during that time. And a lot of that is predicated on they have built a culture here with this Grizzlies team, and they've done it in a quick turnaround time. They have stars in Jaren Jackson Jr. and Ja Morant, but the rest of this team is what enabled them to be good and at this point be in that fourth position. So they're going to have to continue to lean on the team concept while understanding that Ja Morant, Jaren Jackson Jr. will continue to be the horses that get them over the top.
Well, you know what? You're always over the top, bringing us that top-notch information. Hey, B, it's always good to see you. Look forward to hearing you on the call tonight. You always bring that energy. Good luck the rest of the season. We'll see you soon.